Hi my friends, in this video we are going to talk about generic views and the mixins. As you know, we usually write the same codes when performing CRUD operations in Django. We do the same things while handling the GET request, POST request and etc. I mean, we usually write the same things to handle them. The only thing that changes is the models and the serializers in general. Since we wrote the same codes, the developers of Django took it to the higher level and they made our job easier. We need to learn how to use these generic views and the mixins and understand their logic, because in the following lessons we will switch to concrete views. Actually, the concrete views use generic views and the mixins in the background. So in the previous video, we created the models and the serializers. If you haven't watched it, I recommend you. First of all, I create the file where we will write our views. And let's import a generic API from REST framework. I need the model and the serializer. Let's import them as well. Now I want to take a look at the views from the previous playlist. If you remember, we were working on a journalist and we created views from API view. We handled the requests in GET and the POST methods. And we specified our queries and the serializers in these methods. I will close it. I'm going to create a class in the same way, but this time I will use generic API view. Let's see. I want to go to definitions of generic API view. Let's right click and go to definition. Here is something I want to draw your attention to. The generic API view has been created from API view. And there are some explanations here. Base class for all other generic views. You will need to either set these attributes or override get query set. I don't want to read all of this. We will see them in practice. You know, there are some variables here like query set, serializer class. We will define the related query set and the serializer to these variables, and this will make our code much easier. There is even a lookup field, which is one of my favorite conveniences. You know, in order to update, retrieve or delete an item, we need a key to distinguish this item from others. This is usually PK, but slug is also preferred depending on the situation. In other words, we will do this retrieve and the update operations directly without writing any extra codes. Close the generics file here. Let's start coding. First of all, there are some operations I want to do. For example, I want to list all the books, and I want to be able to create new books too. So I need to handle the get method for listing. And I also need to handle the POST request for the creation process. I will go to the definition of generic API view again. And I copy query set and the serializer class variables. I will define them inside the class. So I mean, I will use these variables to introduce my model and the serializer to generic API view. The query set is book.objects.all and the serializer is book serializer. I need to import Mixins from REST framework. If I need to briefly explain what these Mixins do, these are the codes prepared by Django developers according to the operation we will do. For example, if I want to list my books, I don't need to specify any serializer or query set or response manually. These are already ready in Mixins. Let's import and see what I'm talking about. And we need list model mixing for listing, and I need create model mixing for a creation operation. And now I need to add these mixins to my class so that I can use the features of these mixins. Let's go to the source code of list model mixin, right click and go to definition. As you can see, if we call the list method, you see that there are query set and the serializer variables. So list method will use the query set and the serializer we define in the class. I mean, we define here. If we specify in the pagination rule, listing operation will be done accordingly. In short, we are going to call the list method to list books. So we go back to our file, and when the get request is made, we call the list method. So let's say self.list, and what arguments it takes. It takes request arguments and keyword arguments. So I will copy all of them. I save it. I paste it, sorry, and I will add the arguments and keyword arguments here. Besides request, we need to send other parameters as we saw in the source code, such as arguments and keyword arguments. The arguments and keyword arguments are in order to be able to handle if any argument or keyword argument is sent while the get request is being made. I will cover these arguments and the keyword arguments while talking the update and delete operations. Then it will be more explanatory. You know, we don't need to memorize the codes in any way. By examining the source code, we can do all those sorts of things even without reading the documentation. Okay, we will do the same thing for create model mixing. Let's go to definition of create model mixing. We need to call the create method when post request is made. So let's go back to the views.py. Let's say self.create, and what arguments we will send: request arguments and keywords arguments. Okay, I paste it here. We need to add these arguments in the post method. So I save it, and that's all. You may be asking why we are examining the source code. If we start using advanced views directly without knowing where the views are coming from, we can't do anything when we need to override in the future. Okay, it is time to create URLs. Let's go to main URLs file. When a URL request that starts with API is made, I will redirect it to the URLs file under the API folder. So let's create the URLs file under API. I will import views. Now I will create the URL patterns. Don't forget to add as view. If you don't add it, Django will treat a book list create API view as a class. So we need to add as view. Now I go back to the Chrome and I will go to the endpoint I created. I save it and I will rerun my server. Okay, we don't have any error. Let's go to Chrome. Let's go to the endpoint. We get an error. Let's go to views.py. What's the problem? Oh, we forgot to return them. I save it. Okay, refresh the page. Okay, as you can see, we are able to list the books successfully. We have a book and it has two comments. Book name is Les Miserables, writer Victor Hugo, and okay. I'm scrolling my page a bit and as you can see, we have a nice form that comes with generic API view. As we did in the first playlist, we don't write the raw data one by one. Now let's see if the create mixin works. So let's add a new book. Let's say example book, writer me, some description, and then let's choose the date. It's nice JavaScript widget, I liked it. And then click post. We got another error. I know where this error comes from. You know, while the books are being serialized, let's go to serializer file. The books are being serialized. We serialize the comments with the related books. If we don't add read only parameter to comment serializer, we get the error. Okay, I add it and let's save it. Go back to the Chrome, refresh it again. I will try again. Example book, writer, some description. Click post. I was able to successfully add new book. At first, these generic views may have seemed tough. This is perfectly normal. No one can learn these things from the first video they watch. You can be sure that you will be master these topics by imitating the codes I have written in accordance with your own project. Getting errors, encounter problems, and trying to overcome them is the best way to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.